How the Sixth Son Was Born, The Coronavirus Myth by the 10th grade class of Corrales International School. Once upon a time, before the sixth son, Mother Earth coexisted with her siblings, the gods of the sky, the sun, Atlan, and the moon, Itza. Earth loved them very much, but had always dreamed of something more. She designed her own world, full of life and beauty, of human beings made of corn and intelligence, as well as species that could learn to prosper under the four elements she had created. Earth, water, air, and fire. She named it the fifth sun. Mother Earth was so proud of her creation that she finally showed it to her siblings. The moon, fascinated by this world, begged to create something of her own. She fabricated the wolves, creatures with a cry as beautiful as the moon herself, and one that existed to adore her forever. Human beings thrived in this environment for a long time. They loved the animals and took great care of the plant life. For this reason, Mother Earth loved her children very much. The sky gods, Atlan and Itza, were honored that the humans had gifted their skies with planes and skyscrapers. They were constantly blessing them with more technical advances and less climatic problems. They all lived in peace until the humans began asking for more and more in order to achieve their wishes. Mankind spread like never before, poisoning the land that had been given to them and turning their sky to ashes. They cut down trees to make room for their skyscrapers and filled the air with pollution from their planes. With each advance in technology, the children overpowered their mother, leaving her with nothing. Mother Earth grew tired and heartbroken. The animals were tired as well. They wanted their homes back. They decided to convene a meeting of the International Animals Council. There were two animal representatives from each continent. There was a moose and a wolf from North America, a llama and a jaguar from South America, an Arctic fox and a fish from Europe, an elephant and a panda from Asia, a lion and a zebra from Africa, a kangaroo and a snake from Australia, and a penguin and a seal from Antarctica. They exchanged stories about how they were each driven from their homes by humans. The moose and the wolf felt that North America was not as cold as it used to be. The llama and jaguar were concerned about the fires in the Amazon. The fox and the fish talked about how the water was no longer clear in Europe. The elephant and the panda told how they could no longer see the blue skies in Asia. The trees for the lions and zebras were being cut down in Africa. The kangaroo and the snake habitats were being burned in Australia. The penguin and the seal explained how the ice was melting in Antarctica. Even the plants were dying. Something had to be done. The International Animal Council decided to speak with the gods, especially with Mother Earth's siblings, but the two ignored them. After all, they had helped the humans with their advancements and were proud of their sister's children. However, there was a god that heard the animals' request. The god of pestilence. He understood what it was like to feel forgotten, and with all the advances in medicine and technology, this god became weaker every day. Although he was dying, he wanted to leave his mark on the world before he did so. And so the god of pestilence sent his daughter, the princess of the underworld, who took the form of a virus. The humans called her Corona because it was the only thing left of her when she came to Earth on the shoulders of gigantic bats. The bats flew to the cities and carried the virus inside them. Meanwhile, Mother Earth gathered all the plants and animals in the world and provided them with shelter. Listening to the signs, mankind also took refuge, but most believed they were immune, and as a result became infected. Many died as a result of this virus, and never saw the world beyond the fifth sun. Others, however, discovered that their skin became rough and tough. They became corn stalks. That's how the cycle of humans took a complete turn, from corn to corn. With that, the sixth son was created. The animals were relocated back to the world they belonged to. The god of pestilence died with a smile, and the cornstalks, with their roots, reached the gods of the sky and Mother Earth in this new age.